St. John's River Water Management District is removing rough fish as part of its multifaceted approach to restoring water quality in some Florida waterways. Removal, or harvesting rough fish, like gizzard shad and tilapia, has proven beneficial in several Central Florida lakes. Harvest began in Lake Apopka in 1993 and in Lake George in 2012. The district began a commercial gill netting program on Lake Apopka in 1993 to verify that removing gizzard shad together with other restoration measures helps improve the health of some waterways that are overrun with algae. While algae are present in all water bodies, too many nutrients in the water can result in excessive algal growth. Research has found that gizzard shad are not sensitive to these negative environmental conditions, and the gizzard shad harvesting process helps cleanse nutrient-rich waters.
The gizzard shad harvest is one of the many projects the district uses to reduce nutrients in water bodies. Reduction in the nutrients will help reduce algae blooms in the lower St. John's River.
Water quality is affected by the amount of nutrients entering the water body from surrounding lands. Human activities can increase nutrients entering the water, degrading water quality. Water bodies with low nutrients have clear or tea-colored water and many underwater plants. Excess nutrients feed algae that turn water murky green, which blocks sunlight to underwater plants. Gizzard shad harvesting can help cleanse nutrient-rich water by removing nutrients that have accumulated in the fish, and with concurrent land-based nutrient controls can help restore water clarity. Cleaner water promotes underwater plant growth and improves fish habitat. Data from earlier harvests confirmed decreased nutrient levels in Lake Apopka by more than one half, and water clarity increased fourfold from about 9 inches to more than 3 feet in depth. Gizzard shad are a native fish found in most Florida waters and account for 5 to 20% of the total fish population in healthy Florida lakes. However, in nutrient-rich, algae-dominated lakes, gizzard shad multiply quickly and can account for more than 90% of the total fish population. Young gizzard shad feed on microscopic plants and animals, but as they mature into adults, they transition to feeding off the bottom. This bottom feeding activity stirs up sediments that cloud the water and releases nutrients that had been buried in the river or lake bed. The released nutrients act as fertilizer to algae and stimulate algal blooms. Shad grow to about 2 pounds and 10 to 20 inches. They grow and multiply quickly, which can be detrimental to native game fish populations. Harvesting gizzard shad in Lake George, in Volusia, Putnam, and Marion counties has removed approximately 20,000 pounds of phosphorus and 53,000 pounds of nitrogen over the past 2 years.
The elemental concentrations of a number of freshwater fish have been studied in the past by a number of researchers. The concentrations they found in gizzard shad were about 0.8%, which is a small number. When you harvest 1 million pounds of shad, then it adds up rapidly. And so 0.8% for 1 million pounds of shad equals about 8,000 pounds of phosphorus, which are removed from the freshwater body.
All harvest activities are monitored, including weight of the fish and number of fish caught. The fishermen's trip tickets provide daily catch numbers, number of boats on the water, and cumulative totals. The data allows the district to monitor the number of pounds of fish and predict future catches, which helps to interpret the bycatch or recreational fish return to the waters and assists in budgeting for potential future harvests. In 1990, the district contracted with the Bureau of Marketing and Extension Services of the Florida Department of Natural Resources to determine if gizzard shad were marketable as food. The study found no local or international market for human consumption of the gizzard shad, so they are sold for crab and crayfish bait. Gizzard shad harvesting is monitored by the Florida Fish and Wildlife Conservation Commission, and the district operates its harvest with authorizations from the commission. This authorization and close cooperation between agencies is required because of Amendment 3 of the Florida Constitution, otherwise known as the net ban. This net ban precludes the use of entangling nets for catching fish, except for scientific research or governmental purposes. The ban was approved by voter referendum in November 1994 and is still in effect today. Harvest permits issued under the scientific research and governmental purpose provision are restricted by the FWC and the district to qualified fishers only after successful completion of thorough background checks. Harvesting gizzard shad from Lake George is conducted only during warmer months to avoid potentially catching federally managed species, such as the American shad. Additional restrictions to harvesting are enforced to minimize harm to game fish populations and their habitats. Gizzard shad harvesting, along with other district water quality programs, helps to restore and protect Florida's water.